Too far from the continent's power grid, Ushant has to burn expensive diesel fuel to provide electricity to its 842 inhabitants. But that is about to change. In a little more than 10 years, the island plans to become fully reliant on renewable energy.
We realize that we have everything around us we need to produce energy. We have sun like today, we have wind very often, and we have sea currents around the island.
To the southeast, Ushant faces a strait with one of the strongest tidal currents in France. Here, in the Fromveur Passage, the French company Sabella has deployed its experimental device. Placed on the seabed, 55 meters deep, the D10 system converts tidal currents into electricity that is delivered on shore by an underwater cable. It's still a test, but it already covers a small part of Ushant's energy needs.
It's basically an underwater wind turbine. We use hydrokinetic energy, the speed of the water. So the current from rising and falling tides turns the rotor, which drives a power generator.
Put in place last October, the D10 is as tall as a five-story building. It's engineered to withstand extreme oceanic conditions without needing the expensive servicing. Two more years of tests should prove its reliability.
In a few decades, new technologies will make ocean energy a mainstream source of electricity. The industry plans to build 100 gigawatts of production capacity in Europe by 2050. That's enough to provide electricity to 76 million European households.
Many prototypes that have reached the demonstration phase are tested at the European Marine Energy Center in northern Scotland. European companies are considered global leaders in ocean energy, a market that by 2050 will be worth 53 billion euros a year. It's expected to create 400,000 jobs in Europe and boost the economy of coastal regions.
If you look at the number of patents there are around the world, Europe is playing really, really well. I think it's because a lot of different countries are all playing to their different strengths, and they're all seeing a way in which they can make the most of this technology.
The EU has invested over 300 million euros over the past 10 years into the sector that now needs national and private investors to deliver these technologies to the market. Denis Loctier, Euronews.